What's up, Cal Gang? All right, so we got this transverse wave problem. So it gives you this function, y of t is equal to b cosine 2 pi, this, and it gives you these three values. And we have a whole bunch of problems to solve here, so let's go ahead and get started. So part A wants you to determine the wave's amplitude. So what this function is it's just basically in the form of another function that you should learn. If not, you should learn, you should have it on hand. But that function is gonna be, it's gonna be this. So it's y, x of t, which means that y, like its vertical position, is a function of its position and its time. And what that is it's equal to a cosine 2 pi x over lambda minus t over capital T. So this is a function that is in the form of, just with different variables, right? And in this, we have these three variables, right? Which are the same as b, l, and tau. So A, and this is the amplitude in like meters, basically. It's in any, you know, measurement unit of distance. This lambda here is wavelength, also in meters. And then this capital T here is period in seconds, right? That's how long it takes to go. So let's see, what is part A asking? Part A is asking, what's the amplitude, right? So like we just said here, this A in front of the cosine is its amplitude. So this A directly corresponds to this B value here. So that means that its amplitude is just gonna be whatever B is, which is 0.10 millimeters. So the answer wants it in meters, so it's gonna be 0.00610 meters. Just multiply it, or divide it by 1,000 to get it in meters. So 1, 2, 3, yeah, that's right. That's its wavelength. I guess I'll put that equal to A. And so part B is asking for its wavelength, I think. Or I said this is its amplitude. I don't know what I said. Part B asks what's its wavelength. Yeah. So wavelength again is this this lambda here. This lambda corresponds to the value of L. So L is 30 centimeters. So it wants it in meters. So we're gonna say that its wavelength lambda is equal to, you know, divided by 100 to get it in meters. So it's 0.3 meters. That's its wavelength. What's next? It wants its frequency. Okay, so frequency, this curvy F thing, is equal to 1 over the period. So its period is how long it takes to go over that one distance. Its frequency is how many distances it covers in a certain period of time. That's why it's the inverse of that. So this is just an equation you need to know. So then we can say that because this T is here, this is our period, it corresponds to our tau up here, and it gives us our tau is that. So if you want frequency, you're just going to take 1 over whatever our period would be, which is this number, so 3.60 times 10 to the negative 2. And this number is equal to, so it's going to be 27.8. And then the unit is going to be 1 over seconds, which is the same as hertz. So we can say that C frequency is equal to 27.8 hertz. What's part B asking for? It's asking for, let's find out, speed of propagation. So speed of propagation, that's another formula you need to know. A lot of these problems are just knowing your formulas, so you want to just keep solving these kind of problems, and eventually they'll become a lot easier as you learn your formulas. So speed of propagation, that's B. Right, that's the unit that we're using, and it's equal to frequency times the wavelength, right? So we have these two values, so all we have to do is multiply them by each other. So we found that our frequency is 27.8, and that our lambda, our wavelength, is 0.3. So you multiply these together, you get 8.33 meters a second, which should be the right unit, right? This frequency is 1 over seconds, and then this is in meters, so it's 1 meter per second. Makes sense, so let's go ahead and write that over here. V is equal to 8.33 meters a second. What's last? I guess we have E. E is asking, determine the wave's direction of propagation, right? So to do this, basically you just need to look at this formula, right? So in this case, if the t, the value of going to t, right, if there's a negative sign here, it's going to be going in the positive x direction. If it's an if it's a positive sign, it's going to be going in the negative x direction. That's just something you kind of need to know. It's kind of weird, but that's like another thing in the formula, right? So we have a negative here. That means that as t increases, it's becoming more negative. So that means that the wave is going in the positive direction. So we can say e here, it goes in the positive x direction. Yep. I think that's it, right? That's all the questions it has? Yes, sir. Okay, so that's how you do this kind of problem. Just kind of memorizing your formulas. If you can do that, you're going to be chilling. So yeah, good luck on your physics homework, guys. See you in the next video.